This is Winners Longhorn build 363, the first ever Winners Vista build to be shared as of today's video upload. And of course, we will compare it to Winners XP to see if there are changes on this. Spoiler alert, yeah, there is. Or should I say, there are. First look, desktop. The desktop background has been changed to this hashtag or whatever you want to call it. I don't know. There's an identifier which says Longhorn Milestone 3. The taskbar has been changed to light blue, and also don't forget about the watermark. But before we go any further, let's go to the setup. Running the setup from MS-DOS will not be available as it will display the message. This will play a role in future installation methods for Winners Longhorn, which is still used to this day. The interface of the setup is still using Windows XP with the text-based setup as well as the GUI setup. Upon moving to the OOBE, it actually plays different music. It's not real common by Stand Apart, rest in peace, but it's No Hair Problema by Pink Martini. And since the music is assumingly copyrighted, I'm just gonna link the music in the description of this video. Apart from that, there are no differences in the look and function. Now, the login screen. Rather than the blue lunar look, it has been changed to a more metallic blue, I assume. The branding has been changed to Windows Microsoft Windows codename Longhorn in the logo. And there are time and date indicator at the upper right corner of the screen, which is very nice. Back on the desktop. The start menu has a minor but visible change. The All Programs text is, let's just say, gigantically larger than in Windows XP. Apart from the theme, no changes are made except the aforementioned. Alright, a seemingly familiar feature that is implemented in here is available. Windows Trust Manager. Upon obtaining mytvapp.container from future build, it will display this app name and security meter on whether it's safe or not. Does this ring a bell to you? Yeah! User account control, which is still in use up to Windows 11. The interface is still quite unfinished, but the concept of the function is already taking shape. Longhorn can't be Longhorn without one of its well-known cancelled features, WinFS. The feature is already available in this build through the service administrative tools. As of this build, the feature is responsible for new features such as my contacts library and pivots. Don't forget about my hardware, which is a canonical predecessor to devices and printers on later version of Windows. Looking at the Windows Explorer, visual changes are heavily made into it, like the task pane on left, the zoom option which allows you to change the size of the current art tree, a newly designed preview pane named Details which takes up a giant portion of the applications, and pivot which will group items by specific properties such as music group or album. The new context menu now allows you to create photo album and playlist. Within this build, there is also a new concept of file copy conflict resolve dialog which provides more details to the corresponding file. This can be enabled via registry editor. As you can see, the dialog is supposed to be more user-friendly when it comes to resolving the file conflict. But do know that this is still not finished as the layout and design is quite big. And next, this is the feature that everybody knows about Vista and Longhorn. Sidebar, which can be enabled via taskbar and start menu properties. I kinda wish the sidebar in Longhorn gets ported to the RTM Vista or RTM XP because how the concept is just ambitious. You can toggle the transparency, toggle the side, utilize it to bend with the taskbar, unlock it, and add a new tile. Tiles that are available such as clock, desktop manager which splits your desktop into four, this is my personal favorite, MPU which is a programming list, quick launch, search, slideshow, and user tile. There are hidden tasks that can be enabled via registry which are digital clock, and people tile. Another feature that is implemented in Longhorn but not everybody knows is Game Manager, which will be evolved to games in Windows Vista. We got two visible implementations of the feature. The first one is My Games News, which is like news hub for all games that are installed within the OS. This feature does not make it to the final version of Vista, unfortunately. And the second one is Game Definition File, which act as a description file to the appointed game. The example is this, Reset Horn quote-unquote game. It includes with several action/commands. And of course we can't open it due to, well, the game doesn't exist. This bit of Longhorn also introduced an early concept of personalization applet that can be seen in Vista. This concept is built on Avalon, which is a UI subsystem utilizing .NET Framework and .NET Core. Although at this stage, most of the functionality of the program does not exist or errors out due to missing components. As we know in Windows Vista, it bundled with Windows Media Center, which centers around entertainment. This build contains an early version of the component and it can be enabled via add or remove programs with a bit of a pressure to the system. Once installed, the branding of the OS changed to either Freestyle or Media Center Edition. But upon opening the Media Center up, it is broken. For some reason. Welcome Center, which is part of the new features in Windows Vista, is already implemented in here. Although in such a bare-bones state with no visible graphic concept and just a few functions like email, calendar, and quick launch. Internet Explorer has been updated to version 6.05. DirectX has been upgraded to version 9.0. And finally, the Windows kernel has been updated to version 6.0, which is fixed until the final release. And along with beta builds, there are some errors and bugs that are normal for a beta build. This part is unavailable due to unsupported on this platform. Paint will throw an error when it's closing. And those are just known errors from this build, and I can guarantee that there will be more within later builds. At such an early build, this already offers many changes from the build before, although later builds may include smaller big changes. This sets the foundation for future builds, and if that's so, how about